Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the fuck back down. Seem like everybody nowadays Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now? I'ma show you motherfuckers how to act now. I'ma show them how to act. I'ma show you, I'ma show them how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his man's hammer in his hand, feeling like a man. Run, motherfucker, run. Put a po-po, get the gun, put it to your brain like goddamn. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about, I know I can live with that.
Okay, so I decided I'm starting a new series for the channel. I'm starting my cut, the Embrace the Suck cut, as of right now. Today is July 12th. I woke up this morning at 215.6 pounds. Earlier this summer, I decided I was going to do like a small mini shredding series, but I wasn't 100% fully committed and dedicated to that. And I decided if I want to do this, I want to go 100% in, and today's that day. So for the next 12 weeks, we're doing a cut. The goal was to get down to 7 to 8% body fat. This afternoon, we're getting our body fat tested to see what we're starting at. But today, we're starting the cut. The 12-week Embrace the Suck series starts today. Constantly always use when I'm dieting. One, MyFitnessPal to track macros, and I use this app called Weight Drop. It's free. I just go and I plug in my weight every day, and it gives you like really good reports and analytics so you can see trends in your weight, because I don't make changes to my macros on a daily basis, but like weekly, every other week, based off of progress in my weight. And my starting macros are 200 grams of protein, 250 grams of carbs, and 75 grams of fat. The biggest difference I'm making in this cut right now is forever I've just started with 250 grams of protein in the beginning of a cut, at the end of a cut, whether I'm cutting, bulking, maintaining, I'm going to go to 200 grams of protein because I've always just thrown in a bunch of extra. You don't need even 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight, you can go a little bit lower. I'm doing 200 grams and it's easier on my stomach. I don't get as gassy. I don't get like as bloated with too much protein. So breakfast, I'm starting breakfast a little bit later in the day. I'm gonna try to do that. I'm not necessarily fasting in the morning, just getting myself in the morning to wait to start my big meal. So we got 2 cups of egg whites, 1 serving of cheese, a little bit of ketchup. I'm tracking the ketchup because a lot of sugar in ketchup. And then this is 1 serving of Fiber One cereal, which pretty much tastes like rabbit food, but it's a bunch of fiber getting the day started. A cup of coffee, and then 1 serving of strong greens, which goes down this easy. A little bit of sludge at the bottom, so what we like to do is add a little bit more water. Don't let it sit too long, that's what happens. Strong greens, down like that. I can get there with my eyes closed. Exactly 34 minutes after I pull out your driveway, you doubt my phone. Your paper bubble rock, a scripture cover Peter. So my go-to right now is chicken thighs. I've been cooking chicken breast since like college. I'm just over it, I'm tired. Chicken thighs have a little bit more fat, a lot more flavor. So this is one of the things I'll prep almost every other night. Chicken or steak, but primarily chicken. One of my go-tos, my staples while dieting. And I'll show you some of my other favorite food items. My go-tos while dieting on a cut. I'm flexible. I'll fit in a lot of different stuff and I'll deviate from these food items, but these are just my staples. So like I said, always prepped some sort of chicken. This is chicken thighs we have prepped from 2 nights ago. I'm just making some more right now. Also, white rice. We have rice cooker, make jasmine rice all the time. It's just easily, readily available. It digests very fast and easy. So these are 2 things I always have sitting in Tupperware in the fridge, ready to go for a meal. Because if you don't have food prepped, it's harder to hit your macros. You're forced to go out and grab something. So just having those 2 things ready all the time makes my life a whole lot easier. Other protein sources that are my go-to for dieting. Protein powder, at least once a day I'll use a protein powder to hit my protein goals. We have egg whites and whole eggs. Because my fat's gonna get lower over the next couple weeks, primarily egg whites, but I'll throw in an egg or two just because of flavor, get some healthy fats in there. I'll make breakfast sandwiches in the morning. So I'll use Canadian bacon, which is high protein, low fat. And then I found this cheese at HEB, Velveeta. Shreds. It only has 3 grams of fat per serving. So I've been using this a lot lately just because don't waste all my fats on cheese or something like this. My go-to carb sources
are fiber one cereal, just to hit fiber goals. Like in one serving of this, it's 14 grams of dietary fiber. We have fruit, pineapple, and bananas are typically my favorites. Some fruit hurts my stomach, like strawberries. Too many strawberries will give me like stomach pains. They're higher in fructose, so that could be the problem. Some sort of potato, whether that's red potato or sweet potato. Personally, not a fan of like russet because I feel like russet potatoes just get really dry. Tortillas or English muffins for breakfast sandwiches or like tacos. And then rice cakes. I like rice cakes, chocolate rice cakes, put some peanut butter on there, dip them in Greek yogurt. It's like a great snack and they're lower in carbs and somewhat filling. My fat sources, primarily if they're not coming from other foods, coconut oil, I'll throw in with like some chicken and rice, or I'll use it for cooking. Nut butters, whether that's almond butter, this is almond butter, peanut butter. I'll put this on rice cakes, just add in a little bit, but like I said, as the diet gets deeper, my fats will decrease and I really won't use external fats. I'll throw in avocados occasionally too, some guacamole, throw them in salads. For greens, I make a lot of salads when I'm dieting. So this is like baby spinach, I'll use spring mix, I'll use broccoli slaw, I'll take my strong greens, we'll make broccoli or asparagus for dinner with, you know, a meat and a carb source. And then my secret while dieting is this stuff right here. This is fat-free Ready Whip. Per serving, it's 5 calories. It's like less than 1 gram of carb. I'll make sludge with protein powder and I'll throw in a little bit of fat-free Ready Whip. Or if I have like a sweet craving, I'll just go in the fridge. I'm good to go for the day. So I do and will deviate from these food items, but these are staples that I almost eat every single day to help me hit my macros.
So it's Thursday right now. On Monday, we are restocking on all protein flavors. So this warehouse is gonna be completely full. Every flavor's coming in, and we're also gonna do the 5 pound vanilla for whey now as well.
Thing about protein restock on Monday too is our new formula. So previously our protein was all whey. It was all 100% whey. And on the past couple months, we wanted to improve the consistency, the mixability, the flavor profile. So we worked with a new manufacturer in the past couple months. We developed a formula that is, it's about 88% whey, 12% casein. We added a small amount of casein to that profile just to increase mixability, baking ability, texture, and flavor. And like you said, we're also adding a 5 pound vanilla to the line. So that launches here in the next couple days. The new formula will take over the old formula and it's just so much better. We're happy with the product. Hydrostatic testing, which is to find my body fat percentage. Apparently it's like the gold standard, one of the most accurate methods. So we're gonna go swing for a little bit.
So do you have any idea of how this works or what's about to go down here?
I know I get in this, but that's about it.
Yeah, so essentially what we'll do is we'll take your weight here, your dry weight if you will, we'll take your weight and your height. What we're gonna do is we'll have you submerge underwater, everything except your nose and your mouth. So you'll want the water to come all the way over your forehead and eyes, just your nose and mouth will be out of the water.
Okay.
And you're gonna blow all the air out of your lungs.
Facing this way?
Yep. Sure, you hear me through the water. You can lower that head, get that forehead underwater. A little bit more, perfect. Now blow all your air out. Come on, a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. And good. All right, man, you're good to go.
Cool. If you had to guess my current body fat percentage, what would you say?
19.5%.
19.5?
Yeah. What is it?
10.1.
That's not true.
This is the most accurate form of body fat percentage testing. 10.1. today is strictly shoulders and arms. I started off with side lateral raises, front raises with plates, and I like going to do two different variations of shoulder press, one of those being barbell, one of those being dumbbell. Now my training right now, I'm in like an acclimation period before I go into my program, which starts July 23rd. So on July 23rd, we're releasing the next version of Embrace the Suck programming. In the next version of the Embrace the Suck programming, which I'll go into more detail in another video, it's broken up into three training blocks, each one being 4 weeks long. The first is a mixture between metabolic conditioning, strength training, hypertrophy. The second block of training is really a focus on the bench, squat, and deadlift. And then the third block of training, last 4 weeks, is all bodybuilding hypertrophy work. So I'm kind of in an acclimation period before I start the next episode or version of Embrace the Suck on July 23rd. So we're gonna finish up the rest of some shoulder volume with accessory work and then arms.
Bitch, I've been running my city like I am the Wizard of Oz. I don't do this shit for nothing but the family and the squad. Money and everything, tell me now what's that money to a god? If they tell you money make you better than others, then somebody lied. Bitch, I've been running my city like I am the Wizard of Oz. I don't do this shit for nothing but the family and the squad. Money and everything, tell me now what's that money to a god?
So this is one exercise I've incorporating into my shoulder routine. Steph showed me this one. It destroys me, so I want to show it to you guys. So essentially use the cable straight bar, lowest setting. I use 50 pounds. You can do four sets, pretty much as many reps as possible. So keep your back straight and you're gonna pull the weight up over your head, pull it up over top. Try to keep your back in as neutral a position as possible.
So this is gonna wrap up episode one of Embrace the Suck the Cut. Just to go over my body composition analysis from the hydrostatic body composition testing, 217.8 pounds, which this morning I was like 215.6. We have body fat in pounds, 22, body fat percentage, 10.1, lean body mass, weight, 79.8 pounds, and percentage of lean body mass, 89.9, excuse me. So that's where we're starting. The goal, like I said, is to get down to 7 to 8% body fat in the next 12 weeks. So I hope you guys enjoy this series. Tomorrow we have a little special guest coming in from Canada. We have to go to Cabela's, or what is it? We gotta get ammo. We're going to get some ammo. Bass Pro right now to get ammo for tomorrow's guest. So we'll see you in that episode.